welcome to Simple As That. I'm Andrea Keesee, and today we're going to be repurposing some holiday popcorn tins. I found this pin and I thought we would give it a try. So I had a coworker bring some of these popcorn tins to work, and I thought, oh, there we go. That is something I want to give a try. These are lying around everywhere, and they're not very pretty. So I think this pin really kind of made me realize what a great storage solution this could be. And there are so many different ways that you can repurpose this. I've seen repurposed popcorn tins for knitters who can put their knitting yarn inside here and make a hole in the top, and then the yarn naturally comes out. I've seen all kinds of different ways to repurpose these. So today what we're going to do is we're going to cover the popcorn tin with some of this. It's actually a natural fiber. It's almost like rope, except it's a woven ribbon. We're going to put that around the outside. Then we're going to make a liner for the inside out of fabric. You could sew it, but I wanted to do it with a different product, where we're going to use our ironing board and our iron, and we're stitch witchery. And what that will do is, if you don't have a sewing machine, then you can see that you can make those liners without a sewing machine, and it's really not hard. You just need a tape measure and a little ingenuity, and you can do this. So when we come back, we're going to get started, and I'll give you a list of the supplies that you'll need. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to unwrap this ribbon, and this is some ribbon that I found on the clearance. And as you can see, it actually is a woven ribbon, and it's just two-tone. It just has a lighter color and then a darker color on the outside. And what we're going to do is we'll start at the bottom and work our way up. And we're going to just glue this on and cover up the pattern that's on there, the Christmas pattern. So again, you're going to need your handy-dandy glue gun. And we're just going to put a dot of glue . And I'm just going to hold it there until it really sticks down good, because I don't want to start pulling it and it pull away. So we're going to give that a hold. And I'm going to take the glue and kind of run it down the edge so that it doesn't fray. Okay. And we'll undo quite a bit of this ribbon. And now that I feel like that's set up a little bit, I don't think I have to run a piece of glue the whole way. I think we'll just put dots about every so often. And you know, I suppose you could use like a glue dot, but I would worry that it wouldn't hold after time. Now, the only thing I did to this popcorn tin to prep it was washed it in the sink and dried it. Wash it with Dawn just to get any of the popcorn residue or buttery slick residue off of it. Nothing too complicated. Okay, and we're gonna get here. I'm gonna put a couple glue dots on here at the end. And we're going to go slightly past, and we're going to match those stripes up, put some glue down here. Okay, and now we're going to go the other way. Okay, so I'm going to put some glue down here and a nice big glue dot. And what we're going to do is just repeat this. And you know what? I think I want to overlap just slightly. So we're going to move that down just a little bit. So there's just a little ridge right there. Okay? right, we're gonna go to break now. And when we return, we're going to talk about how we're gonna finish it at the top, and we'll move on to make the liner for the inside.
Western Auction and Real Estate LLC is ready to travel to you. Their team includes auctioneers and real estate specialists that will exceed your expectations. They offer experience in agriculture real estate, commercial and residential sales, and farm equipment auctions. Plus, they conveniently travel to your location. And it doesn't stop there. Visit westernauctionandrealestate.com today to shop their online equipment auctions too. For professionalism from concept to completion, it's Western Auction and Real Estate.
There's no reason to dread tax season this year with Weller's Tax and Accounting Service on your side. But tax preparation and planning are just a small portion of what we can do for you. Our firm offers a wide range of services to custom fit your individual needs, including payroll services, bookkeeping, IRS representation, financial statements, business consulting, budgeting, and much more. Weller's Tax and Accounting Service, large enough to offer you what you need, but small enough to give you the attention you deserve.
Psalm 91:4 says, "And under his wings you may seek refuge." There is an organization close to home, ready to help victims of domestic violence, called Under His Wings. They are privately funded and not government regulated for your privacy and protection. Under His Wings serves Graham, Rooks, Osborne, Norton, Phillips, and Smith counties. If you or your family are needing support or a safe haven, call 785-434-6789. Under His Wings, you may seek refuge.
T-Max Trucking, LLC delivers service you can depend on and serves all of Northwest Kansas. They have shale pits located from Logan to Waukini that provide convenient access to your location. T-Max Trucking specializes in road maintenance, and they have a dozer, dump truck, backhoe, and grader to get the job done right. Their locally based business was established in 2012 and is both licensed and insured. Let T-Max Trucking, LLC deliver service you can depend on.
All right, you can see that I've got all of my layers of this fabric or ribbon, whatever you want to call it, on. And I just have a nice clean woven seam back here. And all the stripes are pretty symmetrical. Something I wanted you to be aware of is you could also use rope to do this, and I have a couple different kinds of rope here that would work. It would just take longer, of course. I really like this ribbon and how it looked, because what I'm gonna do now, so we'll set that aside, it's ready to go. I wanna make a liner for it. And I have some of this pretty black and white fabric that's left over. So what we're gonna need to do is get our math hats on, because we're gonna measure our the diameter of the popcorn tin, and then we need to measure how deep it is, because we want it, we're going to make a seam on the bottom, and then we'll make a seam up the sides, and then we'll wrap it around, have a hem around the top, and have a nice liner on the inside. You could sew, but we're going to use stitch witchery. Stitch witchery is it's like a ribbon. You can buy this at Walmart or some department stores carry it. It's made by Dritz, and it's a really handy tool for people who don't have a sewing machine, but they have an iron and an ironing board. You don't have to have an ironing board. You could put towels down on your surface, a couple layers thick. You're not gonna use steam when you use this. You just need to use a nice hot iron. So, and what it does is it melts and bonds the two layers of fabric together. A really handy little tool. So that's what we're gonna use today to put this together. And we're gonna get started by doing some measuring. You'll need a handy measuring tape. And this is a sewing measuring tape, and it's flexible, and it will help you be able to go around. Like a tailor would use this to measure a person's body. Quilters use them. It is a sewing measuring tape, and you would find it in the sewing section of Walmart or whatever. So we're going to measure around the outside, and it's 28 and a half. So let's go ahead and just make a note here, 28 and a half inches around. And then we want, We're going to need to add a little here, so it's 9 inches across. And we want to have a lip on here. And I think I want to have a lip of about 3 inches so that you can see the stripes on the outside. But we're going to need to add a hem. So let's do a 3.5. And then we need to measure the full length, which is about 9.25. All right. So, okay, so 21 and 3/4 inches will get us our total length from, because we will have it come together in the bottom. And I'm thinking, why don't we go ahead and make it an even 22, because that will give us our seam allowance at the bottom. And then we also have the seam allowance here. And then we are going to add, since it's 28.5 around, this is going on the inside. So obviously this is not very thick, but I think we'll go ahead and make it an even 29. So it'll be 29 by 22. Okay, so we'll set this aside. We're gonna clean our area up here a little bit. We won't need the glue gun for a little bit, so we'll put that away. We'll find our lid. All right, now some supplies you'll need. You can use just a good old scissors, and that'll work great if you want to just do that. But for me, I really like, I'm going to flip this over, because I kind of have some glue on there. I really like, when I'm doing crafts like this, to use a rotary cutter. And again, we have this self-healing mat, so we're just gonna use a rotary cutter. And I know that this fabric is, it's gonna be just right at 23 inches. And we are 22, so I'm not gonna cut any off of this. I'm just gonna use that salvage. This is the salvage edge. I'm okay with 23. Why cut it if you don't need to? And then I'm gonna make it 29 inches long. So I'm going to turn my cutting mat and we are going to, okay, so we know this is 24. And 24 plus 5 is 29. So this is going to be our mark right here, and it doesn't have to be perfect. We're going to use the rotary cutter, and I really like these. They just are really fast. You just have to be very careful. The blades are extremely sharp, and we're going to start at the bottom. I was gonna use a rotary cutter, but my rotary cutter is not working. So we'll just grab a good old scissors and we're just gonna cut right along here. Again, it doesn't have to be super perfect. We'll set that extra fabric aside. And so basically we have 29 inches of fabric here, and we're gonna go to the ironing board here shortly. And what we're going to do is turn right sides together, get them lined up fairly well. We will take our stitch witchery stuff is just really amazing stuff. You'll see it here. If you've ever worked with interfacing, this is very similar to that, and it's just on a ribbon roll. So what we will do is we will, what I'm gonna do, since I know that this is longer than what I need, I am going to compensate for that. And I only needed 29 inches. So what we will do, we have to cut this in half at some point here. So I'm going to take my ruler here, figure out what stripe. I'm going to use a stripe to follow along. That way I can just do it this way. We're going to leave this white selvage here, and we need 22 inches. So we're going to put the selvage on the 22 mark. So I'm going to pick this stripe. If you can see that here, this is going to be my stripe, and I'm going to just cut straight along that stripe. Okay, we'll set this extra aside. All right, now we're ready for the stitch witchery. Okay, so we will match, get our stitch witchery. I've already turned on the iron, so it should be ready to go. So I'm gonna go to the ironing board and iron this together. With a stitch witchery, and when we come back, we'll go on to the next step, and I will show you how to create a hem. So, see you in a minute. All right, once we have the side seam done, you can see we have our circle, and we're going to hem this edge. So we're going to use our stitch witchery again, and we're just gonna put a hem all the way around this top portion. So I'll get that going. A nice clean edge. That's going to be our top part. The bottom we have to put together. So what we're going to do is, again, we have right sides together. We're going to slide our stitch witchery inside here. And then I always like to fold that over. Just kind of gives it a little more strength. Since we're not sewing it, it's not like a permanent, the stitch witchery. And then we're gonna let this set for a little bit and cool off. That way we know the stitch witchery has worked. And when we come back, we're going to put it inside of our popcorn tin and we'll have a finished product.
Your home's exterior is the best defense against harsh weather conditions. with insulated vinyl siding, energy-efficient windows, spray foam insulation, and metal roofing from AquaShield Roofing and Construction, you can protect your home from howling winds and ice-cold temperatures. Don't let Mother Nature interfere with the comfort of your home. Call or visit us online today for a free estimate. AquaShield Roofing and Construction. Our team is dedicated to your complete satisfaction.
Make a difficult choice an easy one with Cedarview Assisted Living's knowledgeable and caring staff. Your loved one will be professionally taken care of as they transition into their new community. With movies, holiday parties, planned exercises and games, residents will have opportunities every day to enjoy their time at Cedarview. Multiple room styles are available, ensuring a just right fit for your loved one. Come see Cedarview Assisted Living for yourself next to Sternberg Museum. The care you need, the home you want.
$10,000 and 10, but give 15.
With 7 agents and 3 locations, Hammett Land and Auction Incorporated can meet your every need when it comes to your next sale. Visit them at hammettauction.com and you'll find all their upcoming sales, including farms, ranches, as well as farm equipment and even real estate listings, both residential and commercial. They've been serving Western Kansas since 1983, and with offices in Stockton, Russell, and Hayes, they're always nearby to assist you. Hammett Land and Auction Incorporated. Contact them today.
Norton County Hospital would like to welcome Dr. Todd Pankratz, an OBGYN who is now accepting patients. This means women can receive local specialized care for high-risk pregnancies, infertility, medical weight loss, and various surgeries. With Dr. Pankratz and on-staff physicians, the hospital hopes to serve as a premier facility for women's health care, and this care extends to the entire family as more than 60 babies are welcomed here each year. The Norton County Hospital, dedicated to caring, commitment, and community.
All right, welcome back. Now we have our liner finished, and so what we're going to do is stick it inside and wrap it around the edge. Again, we use that stitch witchery to finish that edge. And then we will just open it up. Voila. There it is. And again, pretty simple little project. You have a nice finished popcorn tin, and no one would ever know that that's what's underneath there. And for me, I have been really practicing calligraphy. So I plan on using this for my calligraphy journals and putting in my special brush lettering markers. But this would be a great project for a teen or a tween to put some of their art project supplies in, or you could use it as a caddy for curling irons and different types of things for their hair. Oh, there are just all kinds of different purposes for this. So for this Pinterest project, it was a win. This was, I don't really felt like I had any issues. Definitely got to do the math for the liner. But overall, I recommend this pin. I think that anybody, even tweens, could do this project and make it fun. So I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you give it a try, and hope to see you next time on Simple as That.